Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's a new night, and we've got four games for you guys this evening in the ESL, ESGA Pro League. I'm with Semler here, and first game up is going to be NIP and Mouse Sports. How do you feel about that?
Well, no, Anders. Mm. I think that the real question is, how do you feel about seeing your Bay got B?
I'm excited all the time. I feel like it's
you are
be,
excited.
Yeah,
that's a good choice of words.
Yeah, you know, there's no such thing as too many Mouse Sports games in one evening. Yeah, especially because we're playing like different maps altogether, I think, and no Cobblestone.
No Cobblestone is the main thing that I'm very happy about for tonight, man. We have so much Cobble.
Yeah, the last couple of days has been a little bit crazy.
Way too
it?
Much Cobble.
Just the last couple of months, basically.
Yeah, like, please stop.
But before we get into it, we actually do a recap going on here so you guys can check out and keep up with what's been happening. So, yeah, check that out, and then we'll start with the Counter-Strike real soon.
Yes.
Hello, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, here to the ESL ESCA Pro League. Coming up here, it is Hellraisers and Envy. Look at the damage being put out here to Envy. Schneider gonna pick up one kill. Kima Shield doing a good job here with a double kill. Nice shot on Schneider, though. He's gonna move a little bit closer. Still got some time here. Hits the shot on Oscar. Stiko's down behind that rock, and Hiroshima jumping and shooting. Not the ideal. So look at the kill there. That's gonna be now a quad kill. Good triple opening here in favor of Hellraisers. Kenny. Oh no. Kenny again. And Hiroshima with another headshot. What's happening? Hiroshima taking down Kucha.
Yeah, that's just.
Oh, MBK stabs Angel. But look at this return. Oscar with a double headshot here. Ladies and gentlemen, here it's SK versus NIP. Over at this A-bomb site, SK trying to see if they can hold on here after picking up a bit of an upsetting round, and Muddy picking up two kills there. Freeze for the shot on Get Right, and it will be a triple kill.
With the communication, with the timing, it was like a sixth sense that they had.
Oh, Kadian gonna pick up the third kill as well. They know where one is. They can just overpower him in the jungle here, and that's what they'll do. Muddy with one more headshot, gonna hit the quad kill. Oh, Forrest, good work here with the SMG, turning around with a pistol. He wants more, and he's gonna get it. SK just beating NIP. That was on Mirage. Bit of an upset game. Pretty good performance, I think, from the Danish squad. The final game of the evening between SK and Envy.
Sheer confidence out of NBK, and he continues to challenge as well. Jumping headshot on Marty and Pit.
And Happy in the middle. No scoping Magic Boy, and it's going to be still up. Oh, a shot from NBK. Yes, the headshot. And now it's down to Freeze here. One versus two. He's going to go for the straight defuse, but he doesn't have the kit. It's going to take forever. And Happy, Grenade not going to kill him. That defuse has been going on for hours. Happy missing the shot. And Freeze, he's going to get the 10-second defuse.
Smoke timing goes down. They might be a little bit leery about pushing through here. In fact, they are going to go for it. Surprise! Happy's here! And he just goes to work. Gets two kills.
Still hands that shot, and now Kenny all on him. He gets the one shot in. The cross jump re-hits Magic Boy as well. And that's going to be the round here and the match in favor of Envy.
You know, when you look at the standings, the current standings, SK Gaming, we've casted a lot of their matches in this group phase. They've always just really seemed to struggle. So when you're going up against the likes of NIP and Envy, you're kind of expecting a one-sided affair. The fact that SK were able to get an upset tonight versus NIP and then put up one hell of a fight versus Envy, that's what we're talking about. That's progress.
Well, there we go. A bit of a recap of what's going on yesterday. And obviously, these were the games. And pretty good overall. I think SK upsetting NIP was a lot of fun, actually.
It was probably, properly a dramatic music as well throughout that.
Yeah.
It was a dramatic evening with SK. I mean, I'm glad that we ended with that because that was the big match of the evening. It turned into that upset win for SK over NIP. NIP just not showing up last night. Forrest, I think, in particular, was the man we were kind of left wanting a little bit. But
Goes with the territory for NIP these days. There's so many unanswered questions that stuff that's going on. So it's a little bit tricky. I'll just leave it at that. Can we adopt a hedgehog at some point? So I'm already looking at hedgehogs on Imgur.
They're adorable, man.
Can we do that?
They are.
I'm completely
adorable,
distracted
man.
Here, but
and they were. It's actually growing up in France. There's like a bunch of hedgehogs everywhere, right?
Really?
So we actually had to put a plank. There was like a whole fountain thing going on in the yard.
Mm.
They had to put a plank in it because otherwise
hedgehogs
would fall
in
and they couldn't get out again.
That's
so,
obviously tragic now.
And yeah, exactly. Look at how cute they are. You can't wake up in the morning and see the little hedgehog dead in there. Like,
you can't. No, I would. That would be
heartbreaking, Anders. That would be
the
heartbreaking.
The question is, are they clean here? Can you, like, if you catch one in the wild, they have like ticks and fleas and stuff like that.
Probably.
I think they have like all kinds of like stuff. So, but I'm wondering if you could get like a cleanly one.
Are we? Yeah.
I'm serious.
I'm pretty sure that if you were to like raise it from the get go, have a little hedgehog like that, it'd probably
be
pretty clean.
Maybe put like a GoPro on its back and
Just let it like waddle around with it. And we'll have it on the leash and bring it around at events.
I feel like we should. For tonight, just to catch you guys up on the schedule and everything else, in case you're wondering, here's the game. I think should be going live soon-ish. We're a little 5 minutes over time here, but yeah, it's going to start off with NIP and Mousesports. Obviously, it should be a good evening. Then Titan versus Pro, Mousesports and versus Pro, and then Mousesports and Fnatic. So a lot of Mousesports. Pretty good stuff, I think.
Oh, this is going to be a real pleasure. Look at this. This good variety of maps as well: Mirage, Train, Inferno, Overpass.
Yeah. No duplicates, no cobblestone.
Yeah, no duplicates, and yeah, just really, this is, we had Mirage yesterday. We'll give him that, but apart from that, you know, Train, Inferno, these aren't maps that we get to see too often in this group stage.
Yeah, and we do have obviously the league standings here, but still TSM and Fnatic, probably too late for anyone to really maybe, maybe Envy could catch up to a little bit if something strange happens in the next couple of weeks, but I mean, we're sort of getting into late stages of the tournament here. So TSM and Fnatic seem to be just so far ahead of everybody else.
I guess the main way is that Fnatic lose a couple of matches because they're behind Envy. I mean, we're looking for 22 matches played throughout this group phase, so TSM, as we can see, still has to play a couple of those, but then, you know, the rest of them, they're starting to close in, and I mean, NIP only have 3 matches left in this group phase. I think it's pretty much guaranteed now that they aren't going to make the cut for the LAN final. Virtus Pro also kind of dancing on the edge. So it isn't pretty for some of the teams that we kind of expect to be sitting at the top of the pack.
Yeah, definitely true. I don't know what to say, really. I mean, it's just it's been a tournament that's been going on for a long time. It's 10 weeks total before you sort of get into it. So it's also hard to keep a consistent level. We've got major tournaments in between all of that. So yeah, there's a lot of stuff impacting some of these teams.
Yeah, a lot of the LAN events, a lot of the travel. Yeah. And then,
I mean, I don't know what TSM, but like the fact that I think they've played what, like 20 matches or something now.
Well, there's also, yeah. I mean, it's good that you talk about this, right? Because they had that period where they were on a hot streak. I think they went like 40-2 or something.
Yeah, and that was like, and they were just playing in this league, basically.
Exactly. So, you know, that 17-2, 17-3 that they have going right there, you know, that was in a hot streak for TSM. Whereas Virtus Pro, they were in a bit of a slump. NIP, same thing, and they are down into like 10, you know, they have like 9 losses, 10 losses. That's not good enough.
And maybe the thing to do is just to try and get, you know, all your matches out of the way as soon as you can. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, just move on to other things, basically, because maybe that's the way to keep the focus. Rather than trying to sort of get back in every once in a while.
Is that going
to
be the thing now, Anders? You know, it's like when you're in that hot streak, teams are going to be looking at you, and well, you're going to be trying to schedule all of your matches for that week, and
yeah,
it's going to be
everyone's
glorious.
Everyone's going to deny it. Everyone's going to be like, no, we don't want to play them now.
I have to, you know, Anders, I might cheat on you.
Oh, yeah?
Because Alex has brought Red Bull to us tonight.
Yeah.
Alex is my new bae.
What a hero.
Oh, my God, you hero.
It's what we need. It's
seriously.
What we need. That's the only thing that's going to keep, you know, the Counter-Strike cast alive. Just to catch you guys up, right now it's carnival time in Cologne. Mm-hmm. We were invited yesterday and someone said, you guys coming to the carnival? It's at 10 o'clock. And I thought, hell yes, you know. Any excuse to dress up in, I don't know, whatever you dress up in, find something somewhere.
Well, they asked me if I had a costume and I was like, well, I didn't know there was a carnival. So I'm just going to say, yeah, you know. Middle-aged hipster. that's what I'm coming as. Yeah.
I think we could have found something out of you, but it turns out it's actually 10 o'clock in the morning. There's no way I'm getting up at 10 unless there's really a good reason to. Any excuse I can take.
I.e. we're at LAN.
Yeah, exactly. So that wasn't going to happen, but we did end up walking around town and people were dressed crazily, so it's great.
There were a lot.
I love it.
You know, I was actually kind of surprised that the guys were telling me yesterday that, you know, there's a lot of SWAT people, you know, a lot of people that dress up as like police and army and stuff like that. And actually, there were quite a few of them. There was even one guy standing outside of a shop, and I had to like do a double take because I thought that he was actually like the shop security.
Yeah,
he was strapped. He had like the gun and everything. I was like, okay.
I mean, I might be slightly stupid, but I did see a bunch of people as well with, like, you know, a police vest on.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, wow, there's a lot of police here, and until I realized, yeah, that's
actual police.
They're just, well, some of them were and some of them weren't. Some of the kids quite clearly weren't police. So it took me a while to catch up to that one. Right, so Vila Lankinen over at Twitter is saying, must be kind of weird casting a game where you kind of know that none of these teams are necessarily going to advance, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So what's the point? Well, this actually could also mean that some of these teams are going to, like, maybe cut loose a bit more and be like, all right, now is a good time to actually test things for us. Because
yes.
Most of these teams don't have a lot of time to test anything new. Once you get into a tournament, you kind of want to stick to what you know works. So maybe we could be seeing a bit of, break from the norm, basically.
I think for Mousesports in particular, right? NIP, who knows what's going on with them, but Mousesports are constantly striving to better themselves. So this will be a good situation for them to do exactly that, right? Try and maybe test some new strats or refine strats that work already. But
yeah, but it's a good point you bring up anyway, so I'm glad that that guy tweeted at us, because it definitely is true. You know, the impact of this game on the overall tournament is obviously less, but it still means there's pretty still a lot that we can get out of it just based on, you know, seeing how these teams are going to be faring. I think Mousesports coming back from SIBO, I think it's going to be a while before they have another tournament, like a long while, actually.
You were saying yesterday that they have like a month off or something like that.
Are they going to DreamHack?
Yeah, I think DreamHack. You have to qualify for that now because it's the base at LAN, right?
So. Yeah, right. So I'm not entirely sure, but either way, after DreamHack, assuming that if they don't go there, then they'll still have like a good month or something.
Yeah, quite a while, yeah.
Which is interesting because that's the kind of time that they could spend and then come back and hopefully they will have improved a lot of things. Almost no team has that luxury right now, so it's a bit of a weird situation actually. In the world of Counter-Strike.
There's so much going on, I think, is the main thing. And so...
And they obviously updated the game with the new sounds.
That's what we're going to be listening for right now, man. That cloppity-clop, right?
Right, so Summer and I are a little bit out of the loop in that sense. You guys probably watching the stream know a little bit more about this than we do, because I actually haven't had a chance to play the game since they updated it, because I'm obviously... Well,
yeah, they updated it, like, yesterday.
Yeah, so. And we're in a hotel room. Although, I'm no longer on Wi-Fi. What are you on, Semla? On Wi-Fi? Hotel Wi-Fi is always bad. Always. I've brought a LAN cable so that I can escape the Wi-Fi. I've never been happier.
Yeah, you did a good thing. I'm pretty Wow. Yeah, once you start hearing, wow. You can really hear the difference. Now I get it, all the clopping jokes.
The clopping jokes. Yeah, I wish we could have found a way to, because we did actually discuss this, if we were going to try and like find some coconuts and bring them to the studio.
Yep.
To like the Monty Python thing of, you know, that could have been fun. I would have gone for it. I don't know. I mean, I like the fact that they're adding more materials to have different sounds. That means map makers can try and explore having audio play more of an impact on the game by having different, you know, sounds at different places.
Absolutely.
It's kind of a fun idea. I think that could like essentially heighten the skill ceiling of the game, which is always
something really loud to me.
Oh, yeah. Maybe that means you can actually use audio more. Like, audio in 1.6, I feel like it was still better than this here. Like, it was easier to hear where people were.
Yeah, exactly. I think, but that was like that in three dimensions, right? Where you could tell how far away somebody was from you.
On a serious note, look at who's sneaking up behind from NIP. That's Alu all the way into T-spawn now. This is very bad for Mousesports, but that's a good headshot to start off with. Alu's going to be flanking, and this is just a question of pure timing intuition right now. The B-bomb site's going to be lost, but if Alu can pick up one or two kills coming up from the back here, that's going to work out. But Chris is holding in the kitchen. No one is going to steal his sandwiches here. Certainly not Alu. He's going to end up going down straight away. Got B will fall to get right, but Nex is still hiding in this corner. Dennis picks up one nice close range block. Going to be Assist going down last, and Nex picking up two of those kills. And overall, great job for Mousesports. It's so weird, right? Around like this, where Alu gets that big of a flank in, should have been better for NIP.
It should have been, but again, like they didn't have any flank going over on A site. They didn't have any info as to whether they were preparing for A site or not. Mousesports could have all been in pit, right? So it could have been a big A site hit coming out of Mousesports as well, with all the pushing all the way up to top mid. It was clear they were going to be on an extremity. It just so happened that there was only a single man holding over on the B site for NIP. The rest of them all focused on A. So it's a bit of a gamble the way things worked out there for NIP. Just didn't really happen. But that's not the end of things here. Still NIP going for the force buy. We've seen how powerful those pistols can be, but already good start here from Dennis. He's going for the wallbang as well onto Alu.
Dennis, that was so close. Well, now are they going to check it? Yeah, they will check it. Dennis being very thorough right here. Getting another headshot, making it a triple down to 2 health himself. Get right in the back lines here with the max 7. Maybe a little bit too quick on the trigger there, but he will get next killed. And are they going to... I mean, they could just go and plant the bomb and be ready. They don't really have to fight Get Right, but they're going to do it anyway.
No mercy. And they save the AK as well, so... No real loss here from Mousesports. I mean, all in all, it's just going to be a grand out of their pocket.
And Danny is asking the important question. How do you have LAN on your hotel room? Almost all the hotel rooms that I've been to have like a LAN port somewhere, but sometimes they keep it hidden. You know where this one is in my room? It's like almost underneath a desk. But I found it. I wasn't going to let them cheat me.
You're actually like scrambling around.
Crawling around on the floor with my broken leg trying to find the LAN. Yeah. Good question, though. Third round is coming up here, and Gobby with a bit of UMP action in the middle, trying to see if he could find a way to get some damage done. Well, they have a stack going on to the A-bomb site for the NIP side, which is a decent idea, but it's not going to work out this time.
No, unfortunately for NIP, again, same as in the pistol, they've stacked up on the wrong site, and they're going to be walking in. Get right, misses the first shot on the man going to bench, and now it's going to get a little tricky for him. He decides to try and play the angle a little bit more close, hoping that Mouseports are going to overextend, but this is really just NIP now trying to take positions to pick somebody off from Mouseports as they try and make their way out of the site. Mouseports, though, they shouldn't be risking any of the rifles. And you already have Gobby still sitting at top mid right now. So if he doesn't see anybody here, this might be the way out for Mouseports. And that's exactly it. They're going to get up into B apartments. They're going to go up onto short if they want. And they should be able to make their way out here without losing too much. I'm kind of annoyed with Dennis for being the guy with the rifle taking the peek into CT.
Yep. I agree.
You just see it coming. It's like a freight train, Anders. You just see it coming from a mile away, and Exist gets an AK for free. Like, that's if we want to nitpick on details, that's a little unnecessary.
It is, and I mean, they had Nex with the submachine gun. He could have actually, he did get a bunch of kills with it, so that's still cool, but he could have been the one charging in there to see what's up. I'm looking for, like, some of these sounds here. I'm just going through the list here. There's solid metal, metal grate, and metal chain link. Like, you end up having to be like, we always make that joke about, like, the $5,000 headset. I'm going to need one just to, like, differentiate. I mean, like, wait a minute. Oh, no. That was the metal chain link instead. He's somewhere else then. Good start here, though. Great trade as Exist and Chris J both end up dying. And Get Right, not taking too much damage, going to fall back in. Very lonely position right now for Freiburg over at the B-bomb site. He's, I mean, Alu is the closest person, and he's really far away. So if they go B again, I know Freiburg has to get a kill and then stay alive. That's double kill would be great, but staying alive is important.
And we already have the rotation coming out here from NIP as well. They're going to be going for that 2-2 setup. Two guys over on the B side, two over on the A side. And Freiburg, he's up in a bit of a tricky spot. Forrest managed to make it here in time to support him. And then between the two of them, they're going to be able to drop that bomb carrier. So Forrest with the two kills. Freiburg still playing. He gets spotted in the end, and they lose Forrest as well. So we're into the 2-on-2, and it could be a 2-on-1. Before I even finish the sentence, Nico catches Alu going in way too hot. I guess Alu just wanted to be the hero. But unfortunately, that role is reserved for Get Right, the man who has a huge win percentage in 1v2 situations. It's never out of the question when Get Right's the last man alive for NIP in this kind of scenario.
Oh, does reveal where he is, just hoping that someone's going to peek him. He's going to walk around there. Gus flick on Nico quickly, and Dennis is in the back lines. Get Right, he doesn't have a kit, so he kind of has to just retreat from this situation. Don't see him making it out. He's going to go a little bit of damage onto Dennis, but even if he got the kill, then it wouldn't have been quite enough time. Get Right, just barely going to make it up that bomb. I think it's not quite going to catch him in CT spawn there. He's just, I think, barely going to survive it. So, going to be another round for Mouseports. And I mean, they had the rotation going into B before everything went down, and it still wasn't enough.
Are they going to go for the force? Wait, Exist? Yeah, he saved that AK. Get Right saves the one gun. Exist goes for the hero op.
Okay.
Okay, then. They actually get a fairly, I mean, if Alu, he stays on that 5-7 like this, they get a good nade count. Freiburg had enough for a full buy thanks to that M4 that Get Right dropped for him. And this might actually catch Mouseports off guard. A little bit of a scary situation, actually, for Mouseports. They're going to have to suss things out here, try and figure out just what's on the other side, because I don't think, apart from the nades, I don't think that they figured out that NIP have actually invested in this round.
No, probably not yet. We'll see. They're going to be finding out any second. They're going for a standard A execute here with one guy controlling the middle, who's going to be very useful later on. See how it's going to play out right now for Mouseports as they are making their way into the site here. Get Right. Nice spray there, taking down Dennis, who took out Alu first of all. Now they certainly know Mouseports, and now they're going to change and adjust. It seems like they are thinking about it. Just lurking on that ramp for a bit. Forrest here controlling the middle against Scott B, and he's going to win that fight. Very important kill, but next coming into it with a headshot running on Get Right.
And Exist is in a bit of a tricky spot. He's got the angle now. Flash to force him around the angle, but then Forrest is there, and from connector manages to pick off Nico. He gets caught, however, by Next, and this is just one trade after another going on to the site. Freiburg starts to leap up. He picks up one, but then Exist is there to lock it down. And in the end, NIP, they managed to keep that head start. They managed to keep that man lead. Very expensive round for them in the end, but they get a round on the board, Anders. It didn't go 5-0, so a little bit more room to work with here for NIP. Whereas there shouldn't be any problem at all for Mouseports to go for a full buy here in this scenario. But no.
Yeah, they weren't quite feeling it. I was wondering if they were going to try and do it, because they probably could have forced it up with a little bit. They could have gone for like 2 AKs and then the rest Tech-9s. Yeah, that's, I guess, an individual choice there.
I mean, this is a good call from NIP, though. They're starting to pick up on this, at least at the beginning here of this half, they're starting to pick up on the tendencies of Mouseports. And Mouseports, right now, they've just been alternating. A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B. I mean, so, right, that's like NIP. They had 4 players on the A site that last round ready and waiting for Mouseports. And, well, this time they have much more of a focus on mid. They have a man on short to support Freiburg, who's up here on the balcony on B site. And Freiburg, unless he gets this spot on, he's going to get overwhelmed by that Tech-9.
It was a good flashbang, but he himself got flashed, so a little bit unfortunate. Dennis opening up 2 of the Tech-9 for us down on the side. He's getting overwhelmed. He gets a kill and a second one, too. He's got 3 bullets left and couldn't get a reload in there, I think. So just ends up going down. That's now Dennis with a quad kill with the Tech-9. I think one of them was the FAMAS as well. And now GetRight trying to sneak in on Catwalk here. And Dennis, is he going to spot him? Is it really going to be the AC spraying down? He knows where he is. And Chris, he's also helped out. Dennis trying to get it. He's not going to get it. And Dennis goes down. But Chris J picks up the refrag, surviving on 7 health. Almost a 1v2 for GetRight then. But what a sick round for Dennis, though. Just running in there and picking up the first 2 kills and then following up with another double.
Yeah, that lead flash. It's so unfortunate for Freiburg that he ate that to the face. Because if he wasn't blind, he would have had the flash. He would have been able to at least pick up 1 kill in that scenario instead of just getting overwhelmed by the Tech-9 point blank. And so what happens for NIP? They find themselves in a double eco scenario. They win a round. They get hard reset. And they're just going to go for it. Exist going for the scout, as we can see. And then Forrest going for the Kevlar along with the 5-7. But yeah, this is actually the worst case scenario now for NIP. I guess Mouseports are going to be able to get 6 rounds on the board, essentially. And that's all you need on T-side Mirage. That's already a very good score. 9-6.
What?
Did he just wallbang Forrest?
Yeah, he did. Look at Forrest.
Forrest is pissed.
That I would be too. That's no fun at all. It wasn't the most powerful wallbang, but yeah, you can still I think see the exit hole over at the wall there. Right in front of him.
He didn't put it through the wood.
No, that might have been the big difference.
He would have got the kill. He would have got the kill if it went through the wood, I think. A little bit of a lucky break there for Forrest.
Yeah, so yeah, I mean, it's true. The damage reduction depends on material, so I think that would right there specifically is almost no damage reduction. They're going to be wrapping around right into Forrest's position. He's close range here with the 5-7, so, you know, 1 click is a headshot, but there's so many people coming, it's very likely he can get a bunch of kills here. He's going to get the first one in, goes for a little bit more. They do almost line up for him, and look at Nico and Nex. They're so low on health right now. Alu and GetRight, if only they could find the right opening, then they could maybe get a kill or two in here, but the bomb is going to go down, and I don't see Mouseports giving up this round. You know, Forrest did do a lot of damage. It's all on GetRight here, sneaking around, lurking as always, like a troll in the underpass.
And he's like, pay the toll.
Exactly.
And Gabi. Gabi's all out of money. He's only got lead.
Pay the iron price.
Mouseports, have they figured out where they can run off this site? Yeah, looks like it. Into CT they go. And no problems at all here for Mouseports. They're going to be able to get out of this in one piece. Or at least the next and Nico cutting it a little close. Nico, you might want to keep running just a little bit more, bro. Yeah, I don't know, Anders. I don't know.
I have no idea what that was. That wasn't even like a thing where it was like it was remotely possible that he was going to survive that.
Okay. Well, maybe he just wanted to spend a little bit more money, you know? Well, it's that feel-good moment, you know, yeah, I got cash, it's all good. I don't mind if I die. I'll just buy a new gun.
New and shiny AK. The other one's been worn out. Smoke into the middle. Quick control here from our sports, obviously. 6-1 lead is starting to a little bit scary. I mean, NIP did lose on this particular map, wasn't it? Yesterday against SK?
Yeah, versus SK.
So maybe they are just not feeling very confident on it these days. It was a map that NIP were able to pick up. I mean, especially when Naoto was coaching and Alu was coming from 3D Max, and like that finish influence seemed to like help NIP play this map. But right now, they're getting wrecked.
that's kind of the way to put it, right? They're getting wrecked by a team actually.
They're
sitting on
so
a
many
5-8 scoreline. Yeah, they've only played 13 matches so far, Mouseports. So actually, this match right now for Mouseports.
This evening
is that, yeah, they have 3 matches tonight. Mouseports, if they come out of this with 3 wins tied up 8-8, I mean, that puts them much closer to the top. I mean, there could be that. There could be that legendary run, Anders. Could be. I mean, you know, miracles happen. NIP, the run is over. I think that's why we're seeing them really struggle. I'm not going to beat around the bush there.
Like, yeah, I was going to say, you're not even soft-selling that. You're just like, that's it. That's done.
But there's still a chance here for Mouseports. So that is very interesting. So now, at least, we kind of know why Mouseports at least are going to be just, you know, focused so hard.
Yeah. Dennis, so focused, he's jumping and shooting with the AK, which is obviously a big risk. And Exist is going to come and punish Herm for it with the grenade in hand. Dennis is going to be gone. Godbeater to follow soon. That was Forrest picking up the kill. Leaving next, and Chris and Nico here, 3 versus 5. Should not be a losable situation here for NIP. They know where the push is coming from. Exist picking up the one. Get right. Doesn't matter if he can see anything or not. He's going to pick up the kill, and NIP will finally slow down Mouseports a bit.
And he got Exist's Dragon Lore back. Even Exist has a Dragon Lore. What is the world coming to? Plenty of money, though, for Mouseports to go for the full buy here. Ooh.
What's that?
Nice. NBK has got more work done on his tattoo in the meantime.
Yeah, we were briefly distracted by what popped up. Not at all bad, Nathan. 7-2 and moving into the 10th round. We'll see if NIP can continue on this particular path here and maybe make it back here in the first half. Exist with a good start, taking down one, but a lot of trading going on. And Get Right's going to be gone in the middle. Dennis picking up another headshot. Exist is gone now. It's down to a 3 versus 2. And Alu and Freiburg have to stay alive here. Alu out in the open with the open hand. And he goes down. Freiburg trying to bring it back, getting the one shot, getting another shot on the bomb carrier. And now Next coming in, just clicking away, taking this fight against Freiburg. No fear at all. And Next will hit the headshot there. I mean, that was not the prettiest of Counter-Strike at the end in terms of just taking raw aim fights, but... Mm-hmm.
It's a courageous way to play Counter-Strike, though. Right? I think we can say that. It's a brave way.
It's the manly way to play Counter-Strike.
Just go in there, take that fight, win that fight. I mean, that's it, right?
Maybe
no subtlety.
Maybe NIP dared Freiburg to take the fight. They were like, I bet you're not brave enough to do it, Freiburg. I bet you're not. You're scared. You're not even going to try and do it. And Freiburg's like, all right, bros. I have to. Because the bomb was down, so Freiburg could have played some different games there.
They chose to go for the straightforward approach, and now, well, NIP go for the force buy, but again, Mouseports walking onto the B site. There is a man lurking in the smoke. Everybody, quick rotation from NIP, and what was that? No, okay. Nico gets the kill on Kitchen, but yeah. I thought that Next actually got the spray transfer onto the man at the kitchen window there.
It did look a little bit scary there, but still, I mean, the speed here for Mouseports, and that's gonna crack NIP's economy once again. Looking a little bit scary here. NIP, look at this. It's a lot of the mat rounds, at least, have been down to, like, very close 1v1s.
Now, if the pattern holds true, Mouseports should go to the A site. And, yep. They're literally just going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, site to site. That is the game plan for Mouseports. The game plan for NIP, though, after that force?
Yeah, it's a game plan that's too elaborate for NIP to keep up with. Like, they went B last time, and then A, and then B, and then A. I can't figure out what the next pattern in this, like, I don't know what the
but
next line
is. That's the mind game within the mind game, Anders. When are they going to break the pattern? When are they going to go twice to B? Ooh. Oh, that's a little unfortunate there. Forget, right? He actually got a bit of that flash to the face. Failed Molotov as well. And well, for now at least, it's just drawing a little bit of attention. Again, Mouseports, they go for that mid control. They're going to be starting to work their way up connector. They've got control. They like to put Dennis up here, but it seems like there's going to go in force. It's going to be that collapse onto the A site. Freiburg able to pick up 2 headshots, though, with that P250. He gets caught in the end by Chris J, and, well, it's down to Forrest and not for long. So apart from Freiburg's heroics, again, playing bravely.
I feel like you can kind of tell at this point here that the Next is sort of like tuned in. He's just running and shooting with the AK. Dennis is doing a really good job too. But like Next way of just running into bomb sites and picking up kills with the AK is kind of scary. I hope he can maintain that level all throughout the evening. That would be super cool if he could just keep doing that. Right now it's 10-2 and moving into the 13th round. AWP on Dennis. Not on Chris, which is a little bit interesting. Maybe just a close spawn to the middle. Going to be picking up Alu here, and it's finally a buy round for NIP, and it starts like this.
They want to keep it short and sweet, Anders. That's just so unlucky for Alu as well. I guess he had a little bit of a late spawn, or not the best one. Forrest, though, with the Lurk and Underpass, that's going to pay off. Big, and the follow-up flash, he gets the second spray on the Next, but Dennis is able to pick him off before he can get out of harm's way. Get Right is there to take out Nico, though, and now NIP actually have that man advantage once again. and the aggressive push here from Get Right into T-Spawn. Chris J hears him jumping around, though. That's going to be a free kill for Chris.
Yeah, kind of an unusual mistake on Garrett's part. I'm wondering if he had a sense that they were rotating into B, because otherwise that's a little noise to be making.
15? I could see Garrett getting a little miffed. It's like, what is this guy doing here?
I'm supposed to be lurking. Well, 45 seconds now, and Chris and Dennis still making their way up into apartments towards that A side of the map. They do have two Molotovs. No smokes, though, and like a Molotov is not going to keep Exist from shooting them here from CT spawn. Maybe push him back a little bit, but a smoke would be great if they realize he's there. Unless they can just shoot him straight up.
Yeah, that works too. Plata o plomo.
I think that's a Narcos reference, yeah. the Netflix one. I haven't actually watched it yet, but I know about the reference for different reasons.
It's what is silver or lead?
Exactly. Sis going to be coming out there, and that might have been the big moment. If he gets one kill, even if he can't stop the bomb, there's a really good chance for them to win it now. Let's hold on Freiburg here, watching it for the middle, just trying to see if he can actually get the spray through. It's almost done. And now the Molotov going to deny one path to him. That's very unfortunate. Freiburg now down in the middle, trying to get it closer, going to get the one headshot in. Chris is hiding in the back lines here. Freiburg moving closer. Chris has got the Tech 9 out, and he's going to get that shot. Even without the headshot, that would have been a kill, and Mousesports are going to pick it up here.
11
rounds
on the board.
Can you tap out of a Counter-Strike match? Can you just say, we're done?
Like, tap out?
Yeah, just like, you know, hit the mat.
No, because, you know, that would remove the chance of a comeback, Anders, and that's no fun. That's
still
actually the League of Legends reasoning for not having any surrender.
So. Good job, Sam. Thanks for the... I like it.
Yeah, so yeah, I think Nip wouldn't mind at this point, but Nip are pros, they're gonna keep going at it. They're gonna try their best. Mousesports though, they're clearly hungry. And they've definitely got this match within their hands now. 11-4 at the end of the T side. I mean, well, 11-4 ideally for Nip could still go the distance and end at 13-2 here, which is likely because NIP have gone for a bit of a... Well, this seems like a full force from them.
Assist, big opening here, missing a lot of shots, but still making it work. Let's see if Mousesports are going to react to this in a reasonable way. Falling back there from Dennis might not have been the best move. Freiburg going to get shot in the face by Next, and in the middle, Assist almost getting the kill on Chris there. So they have the bomb site, but not the bomb. And at this rate, they might never get it there.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it. I mean, Next is waiting to see if he can pick somebody off, rotating over to Kitchen. Get Right manages to win that duel, and Chris is going to roast alive. Literally, no, Exist gets the kill in the end.
There's not a lot that Chris could have done, but it was kind of funny. Trying to make it into that site.
No worries for Mousesports, at least. They have the money to full buy. NIP do as well now because of that eco win, so they've got everything they need. And well, now, 15th round, is it going to be 12-3? There's going to be 11-4. I mean,
that last round was a weird one because Mousesports have won a lot of their rounds here in the first half by just being very, very fast. You know, they just run into bomb sites and overpower NIP. But then, you know, they play up against what's just a pistol armor round and they slow it down so much. And it seems to be what people do now. Whenever people hear Deagle, the first thing they do is think, let me just slow it down and see if I can take this fight. And it almost never works.
Did I just hear like a Western, you know, like, the bullet just zinged? All right. Well, shots all over the place. Get Right manages to pick up one, two, and God B is going to find Alu, but Get Right holds his own. Still alive on balcony, removes God B from the map. It's going to come down to Chris J, but not for long. Quad kill for Get Right at the end of the round.
He tasted his corpse.
He tasted.
Actually, maybe, I mean, Get Right is probably one of the friendliest people you'll meet in Counter-Strike. Maybe he was trying to revive him.
Well, you know, like I'm a little surprised to see him go for that because that's actually one of the old ways of tilting Get Right.
Yeah, but I think he was trying to revive him. I think it was like a heart starter, you know, just the electricity.
No.
It probably doesn't work
Don't
on people who shot in the face.
Yeah, exactly. I just shot you in the face, but still. I mean,
let's get that heart
that's
going.
Fun though, because that's actually what some players tried to do that versus Get Right Happy. You know, Get Right was never very appreciative of that because saw that as being BM, you know, if you're shooting your opponent's corpse after he got him, you know.
Yeah, I think, I mean, in that way, Happy is like, I mean, not just because he's French, but there is like a you know, fine wine thing going on there. Like, you gotta like, learn to appreciate Happy's level of trolling. It's even taken me some time, because I think actually Danish Counter-Strike players are, like, particularly salty. So, like, when I, for the first while, especially when Happy was, like, in LDLC or whatever, and I thought, who is this kid, like, trying to be all, you know, like, up himself? And so I think that kind of triggered me a little bit too. Now I think it's hilarious, and I really love when Happy goes, like, you know, full troll mode.
You just need to spend a bit more time on HLTV. Now you see the light, Anders.
Exactly. Well, I mean, if you compare Happy to HLTV, I think Happy comes out pretty favorably. the levels of trolling that goes on there, it's quite amazing, actually.
And what does he do? First thing he does, guys, brings up HLTV. Don't you dare look at the forums. Don't do it.
There are some really, really good ones. Some really good ones. I think around the time that Olaf had that awful game at the last major, the one where he went like 3-19 or something like that, there were a lot of good threats on HLTV.
Minus Olaf plus Hunden.
Yeah, that was one. I think Tiltmeister was another name that somebody coined. I think people forget to have fun sometimes. Not HLTV though.
HLTV,
definitely not.
Fun is all that happens there, man.
Yeah, good times. All right, well, we should be moving into the second half any minute. We're just missing one Mouse Sports member, and then we should be good to go. If you could choose a pet that wasn't a hedgehog, though, what do you go for? Just exclude cats and dogs, because everyone has one of those.
Yeah, exactly, right? You know, it's kind of a tough one. Except, I mean, hedgehogs are super cool. Ferrets seem cool, but then they smell if you don't wash them enough, so no. That's not
I would
very
actually,
cool.
I could very likely go for like, a pygmy hog, like a pig.
A pig?
They're so cute, aren't they?
Yeah,
like,
they are.
They're amazing.
They are really cute.
But it's so just, could be
like,
one of those.
You're thinking long-term investment there, right? Oh, I'm so sad. You died. And then, you know, like, bacon.
But now bacon. I don't know if I could. I might not be able to do that. Like, I'm not anything, like, close to, like, a vegetarian or anything, but...
You couldn't do that? You know, that's the thing. You're honoring your pet at that point, Anders.
Yeah, I realize. It might not be logical.
You're going to be with me. Always.
Always. I don't know. Hedgehog, a pig.
Hedgehogs seem like the pet of the year, though. They look super adorable.
I could go for... I think otters are cute as well.
Yeah, but they, like...
They're pretty hard to manage.
Yeah, exactly. I think they need like a lot of water and everything. Right? That's the problem. That's why
high maintenance pet.
I couldn't imagine having a dog, right? Because then it's just like dogs need space, man. And not those little rat dogs. Like those dogs, whatever.
Rat dogs.
No, nope. I mean like a real dog. You know, if I was gonna have a dog, it's a dog that when I wake up in the morning, I pour some coffee in his bowl because he's that big, right? Like he needs it too. So, but you need space if you're gonna have a dog like that, right?
That is true. Well. We'll come up with some more later on, more pets to be decided.
Yeah, well, I mean, then you get like the what were they, like the little sugar gliders? Those are pretty cool.
Oh,
you know, the little things that like they're like little rats, basically. Well, little rodents.
Yeah, I know.
They can like glide around.
It's like a flying squirrel almost.
Yeah, I had an aunt who had a couple of those, and they were pretty nifty. You walk around with those in its pot in your pocket, right?
Can you train them to deliver like your deliver things?
The thing is, I think like whatever they try to deliver is probably gonna weigh more than they do, so might be a little hard for them to glide gracefully through the air.
Someone's saying get a chicken as a pet.
No.
Actually, where I usually we had chickens. We were in an apartment where we had them like on the. It was really weird. Mouse Sports and NIP. Now second half is coming up. Finally, we're going into Mirage here, and NIP have been just beaten up by Mouse Sports for a good 15 rounds, almost at least 11 of them. So really hard time for the Swedish team here on this particular map. But Gobby opening up with a good shot there. Flashbang comes out next. It's going to take one, doing some good damage. The bomb is down as well. Alu going to get a good refrack in here. Gobby doing more damage. Actually going to... Well, Dennis getting the kill and assist here. Looking bad for NIP.
Yeah, and all of a sudden, kind of turned south for him, especially as Gobby and Chris J, they just rotate in. Gobby stayed alive, did a great job. But the fact that they were able to rotate in very quickly and just not allow NIP to get out of the apartments, that was the key play there. Yeah, it is a zing. Like I was just like, is this a Western now all of a sudden? You know, they're like shooting bullets. It's like, bang, bang, bang. Like just going all over the place, right? Spaghetti Western style.
It's high noon.
Yeah.
I don't know how many people have been playing the Overwatch beta, but... that's Forrest going down to 30 health from a scout through a smoke. NIP have bought up. They realize it's now or never. They have to make this work. If they don't come back into this game right now, their mouse bots are going to take over with and just run away with it. But we'll see if it's going to be a thing or not here. I mean, with them already low, and they've already used pretty much all the smoke grenades. So now it's just trying to rush into a bomb site with very little backup. Robby gonna charge in. He got shot in the face, but he's just still alive. Got the pistol out. Trading places in the smoke. He finally goes down, but Chris has picked up a double kill, and he gets another one in there for the triple. It's gonna leave Alu alone with the bomb, and very likely gonna be a bomb plant here. So a bit of success, but they probably need to win this round.
Yeah, what in the Sam hell are we watching, Anders? They will be able to pick off Alu in the end. He wasn't able to actually do anything, but Gobby, if you had a P90, yeah, like run in there, just hold down spray. Sendler doesn't remember the 1.6 bullet ricochet sound. Was there a bullet ricochet sound?
Possibly. I'm not gonna lie, it's been a long time since I played 1.6, so...
Yeah, I can't actually remember if there was a bullet sound or not. No. Not remembering.
I mean, the problem for me with hearing anything is that whenever I talk, I hear my own voice too, so for like a lot of the game sounds, I'm not hearing the way that you guys are out there, so... We'll see. I promise I'll go back to my hotel room with my LAN cable and figure out. Oh, Kreiberg. Not going back to any hotel room, just straight into the grave there. No head armor and one click and he's gone. Oh, Chris. Merciless. Garrett's actually going to make it out of apartments there. Grenade not doing too much damage. But Chris is going to be getting a good triple spray down there, so. That's going to be another round in Mouse Sports now. I mean, it seems like they're just not going to let up here. 14-4, but I'll go back to my hotel room and listen for all these sounds and see if I can figure out how it works.
Well, I mean, I don't even care if it comes from 1.6 because it's been like so long now that to me the first thought is Spaghetti Western.
Spaghetti Western.
So that's what it's going to sound like, guys. Sorry. You know, if that hurts your 1.6 sensibilities, I think what Spaghetti Western is much cooler.
1.3 was obviously the better patch anyway.
Okay, yeah, I think we can both agree on that one. Kreiberg going ham.
He didn't even touch the ground, did he? He shot that bullet midair, I think, with the AK follow-up kill as well. And Nico and Chris both going to be gone. Some good mid control here for the NIP team. 4 versus 3 right now. And NIP finally fighting back, although you can't help but shake the feeling that it might be a little bit too late right now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, fair trade there. Gobby getting shot in the back, though. Timing didn't really work out for him. That could have been great if he'd just taken out Exist for free. Nice dunk nade onto Dennis as well in connector. Right in jungle. And that was a very weak smoke get right. But he doesn't dare push through, Dennis. He's too low on HP to be willing to take that fight, it seems.
Yeah, left a bit of a gap that could have been exploited, but... not sure. Nex trying to not make any sounds on the ladder here that might give him away. Good round. I mean, when you get an opening like that with the AK, then there's not really much left that gives you so much mid-control, and the fact that NIP slowed it down after the initial fight, just really smart play. They don't run into any kind of big setup from our sports or another stack going on in the bomb site. So just overall, like, really basic Counter-Strike for NIP, but it worked.
And they're definitely making Mousesports work for it, at least. Get right catches next in the end. Next, who's just kind of jumping around, hoping to find something. Luckily for... Mousesports, it's not going to be the end of the world. They still have plenty of money to go for a buy here, so doesn't mean that NIP are going to have the chance to develop too much momentum if Mousesports can just shut them down right here. Unfortunately for Chris, he's just... okay. Wow. That Nex is a true teammate. He literally just went Glass Cannon M4 so that Chris Jane could have an AWP, because he was the only guy who had the money for it. That's a teammate right there, ladies and gents. Boom. And there you go. Chris... Paying them back for that sacrifice.
Yeah, some heads up thinking. Chris, obviously, having seen that smoke before, realized that it was going to be a gap in the corner. But Freiburg again controlling the middle here for NIP with a double kill. And now we're 4 versus 3 in favor of the NIP team.
Anders, that hurts my brain.
What?
Why did they do that? Chris J just gave them the entry frag. They could have slowed down the match and not taken any risks and just made NIP make the error. Of having to run into a situation, and no, they just fed 2 kills to Freiburg.
I mean, that is generally how we prefer people to try and play. Leg shot in there on Freiburg, but he's still alive. And now, are they going to try and push up behind Existus up in those apartments, waiting for somebody to show themselves? It's going to be next to making the jump, and Chris turning around. Not going to catch anyone just yet. Dennis with the kill on Get Right. It's still going to be favoring Mouse Sports slightly because Freiburg is low, and Dennis is controlling this bombsite. Freiburg, he might be going down here, very low on health as well. Flash comes out once. Backup is being called for. They're all making their way in, and Dennis is doing a great job of buying time and doing the damage here. Freiburg going to go down. Tech9 is out as well. And backup is called in. Forex is going to get the one headshot. Missed shot from Chris, and he goes down to Forest. Now it's all on next. One versus two. 15 seconds here for the bomb plant. Are they going to be able to make it? The bomb gets dropped, but Forest gets a headshot, and NIP going to win the round. If next could have fallen back, then maybe that could have been their round, but NIP barely make it out, and that's going to be just a little bit of a comeback into the game here, but it still feels like it's so far away, Semler.
Oh, man. It's so expensive as well.
I can't fully believe it.
It does feel like it is so far away there, Anders. You're right. That's just so unfortunate for Nex that he goes for the man with full HP instead of picking off Forest. Perhaps didn't realize just how far along that bomb plant was. There we go. Again, challenge in mid. Dennis with that M4. Just gets caught right off the bat, so he doesn't really get anything out of it. And the rest of Mouse Sports are on pistols, so this should be a pretty straightforward round here for NIP. Shouldn't be taking any more damage than they already have. And Alu finding Gobby looking the wrong way is a pretty nice start. Follow-up kill on the next, and Nico trying to rotate it over from the A site, but Getright's waiting for him on the other side of that connector smoke, and there isn't a whole lot that Nico can hope to do here.
And I guess round difference, especially for Mouse Sports being a little bit behind them in the league right now, could be really important for them. So it would actually be great for them if they could just close out this game quickly.
Yes, absolutely. Round difference would be huge. So, I mean, it just needs to be a decisive victory here for Mouse Sports. Next time that they buy, they have to shut Nip down and just lock down this map. And they need a strong confidence-building start, I think, to this night, especially if they have three maps coming up, or two maps after this one. And all of them are extremely important. Mouse Sports right now, they're right on the edge. They need to win everything left in this pool for themselves here.
I'm also wondering if, considering they do have three matches tonight, Mouse Sports, if it's going to affect them if they end up with sort of a bad end to this game. I mean, I don't think they're going to lose it, but if they end up, you know, at a 16-13 type victory, you could still feel like, wow, that was actually pretty bad on our part. We should have been able to close it out. Maybe that could impact the rest of the games. An early tilt from Mouse Sports.
Certainly isn't going to help things. And if they keep making mistakes like they did in that buy round, it's not going to be pretty. Flash on the other side of the short. Only catching the one man. Gobby still here. Picks up the one. And we need to see, can Chris actually capitalize on this? No, he will not. Forest with the double. And Alu takes out Nex in the meantime, who was playing from Van. Free entry onto that site in the end. They only lose Freiburg, but he's the entry fragger, so if he dies and the rest of the team get in there and get the bomb plant, he did his job just fine.
Nico blowing out the vent. Very audible to everybody who's nearby, and Exist is going to be the one to pick up the kill. So Mouse Sports still just two rounds away, and NIP, they need to win another 8 rounds in a row to win this fight. Or 7 in a row, I guess, works. Then we're in overtime, and anything could happen at that point. It is a really long comeback here. Chris going to pick up the AWP, and there is one on Alu. Chris with a fairly close spawn to middle here, so we'll see if he can beat him to that mid control. Actually, not even going to try, just run into B instead.
Again, they just changed it up. Chris is, he's done with the whole window peek game. He's trying to change it up. And he might actually catch somebody here, taking a step too many here on this Nip side at the top of mid. Smoke is going to go down to block off window, and he gives it away. He still gets the tag, at least, but he gives away his angle, so he won't be able to pick up a kill. Instead, he's going to try and focus on the B apartments themselves.
And up in those apartments, Exist is already very low. So actually, two members of NIP right now dropping just a little bit low on the scale, a little bit scary, and also Get Right now to follow. Chris going to finally get that shot in on Alu, so Terrace side AWP is gone. Chris with another shot, taking down Get Right, and now it's going to be 2 versus 5 here. Looks like that was about as far as NIP was going to get. Existent Forest creeping around, but there's no way to win this.
No, it's looking pretty grim. I mean, Forest is going to... I mean, he can... It's almost as if, like, Forest could just sit and wait. He still hits the shot. Fantastic shot onto Dennis and connector. It must have clipped a little bit of the wall there for Dennis to survive, seeing as how that was a headshot. Yeah, God B.
The infamous lag spike.
Mm-hmm. I don't think there's a mystery to anybody at this point, though.
Hailing the end of the game, as we know. That bug surely must be patched out at some point, you know.
Well, yeah, it's like server formatting, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's the server just rolling over, going to the next map, so it's kind of on ECA.
Fantastic flashbang. It caught the window frame and actually bounced back in there. I kind of like that. Forest is going to end up going down, no big surprise, and 15-8 is going to be the scoreline moving into the ninth round of the second half, and we'll see how this is going to fare for NIP. They've got the money at least, and an AWP, but we've been tipped as to the result, Semler.
Yeah. No, they've definitely got it in the Manders. It is going to be NIP with the full buy. There's always a chance in CS. They could run it back seven rounds in a row. Nip Magic. We've seen it happen in the past. It's going to be the A execute. Straight up, through and through. Three guys into apartment, two down on the pit. And I don't see Nip wasting too much time. We might actually have to flash in. Yeah, we do. And Freiburg, full flash. Not going to be able to get anything out of that. Very well done there by Mouseports. And they're going to be in a perfect position to clean up the rest of NIP here.
Wow.
Very, very solid defense.
What a shutdown. I mean, that initial kill just destroys so much of that push there. The people coming in from apartments probably were meant to be, I mean, apart from Freiburg for setting up that smoke, he's also supposed to be flashing them out of apartments, right? So once that fails, then they just run in with no cover through the smoke.
YOLO.
Yeah. Not at all a fun time.
Get right, doesn't really have too many options here. I mean, 1v4, they've already rotated a man over to the B site. I believe that's Chris, so he's going to be watching. He's got that AWP to hold that long line. There's a man at top mid now as well. And he walks right into next, so there we have it. Mouseports picking up the win versus NIP. NIP just not feeling comfortable on Mirage right now. They can't really seem to get anything done. Last night they lose to SK. I mean, these are, considering NIP, you could say it, you know, these are inferior teams compared to NIP that are managing to beat NIP on Mirage. So maybe NIP are just saying, well, we need to put some work in on this map. And that's their reasoning behind it. We need to put some work in on this map. And so just because we might be a little weak on it, we don't really have anything to lose. Let's go ahead and just keep playing it regardless of what happens.
I think I've reached a point where in terms of NIP now, I don't want to make any more predictions, you know. I just want to say, let's just wait and see what happens, you know, because it's all too confusing, basically.
December.
Yeah, you know, it's too confusing right now. If you've been missing any of the results here in the ESL ECA Pro League, go and check out the score, esports, and also check out the iOS and Android applications you can download down there. Mm-hmm. For your phone, so you can keep up with everything, and also, you know, obviously the articles on their stuff too. So definitely go and check it out. That is the first game, but we do have three more coming up, and they're all very good, in fact. So should be still a fun evening ahead of us. A lot more Mouseports, and we've got Virtus Pro Fnatic and stuff in there too. So it should be. It should be an enjoyable evening. How long till the next game? About 8 minutes?
About
10
minutes.
Yeah, 10 minutes.
It's a CS, so it's probably going to be like 15 20. Minutes, yeah. 20.
Should be in about 10 minutes, guys. Yeah. So stay with us, and we'll be right back.